Hello dear students, again Vinay is here to welcome you in the class of physical education and sports science. Right now we are also doing a parallel class of UGC NET paper 1 for teaching aptitude, in which in the previous class we were talking about the Bloom's taxonomy and their instructional objectives. Today we will discuss about the second part of instructional teaching and instructional objectives that are given by Gagne and Briggs. Okay, so G and D जो क्लासिफिकेशन है टीचिंग और इंस्ट्रक्शनल ऑब्जेक्टिव्स का, उसे हम करेंगे. दिस इज आवर 15th क्लास, 15वीं क्लास है. और आगे बढ़ते हैं, फिर करते हैं इसके ऑब्जेक्टिव्स, देखते हैं कि वो क्या बोलते हैं इसके बारे में. द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ लर्निंग अकॉर्डिंग टू द रॉबर्ट ग्रेन इंक्लूड टू द फाइव काइंड ऑफ लर्न कैपेबिलिटीज. पांच टाइप की लर्निंग कैपेबिलिटीज होती हैं रॉबर्ट के अनुसार. अच्छा, बहुत कम इनका नाम जो है वो रॉबर्ट यूज करते हैं, ज्यादातर लोग इनका गेन नाम यूज करते हैं, ठीक है ना, गेगन. राइट, सो इंटेलेक्चुअल स्किल, कॉग्निटिव स्ट्रेटजीज, वैल्यूएबल इंफॉर्मेशन, वर्बल इंफॉर्मेशन, एटीट्यूड एंड मोटर स्किल्स. राइट, द नेक्स्ट थिंग इज दैट द गेगन टैक्सोनॉमी इज perhaps the most popular of many taxonomies, like Bloom's taxonomy from 1983, right? Its popularity can be attributed best for the ability to clear distinguish between the abstract and concrete definition of learning. So I have already explained you both these terms, concrete as well as abstract. Right, now we will focus on the all five skills. Right, the very first skill is intellectual skill, second one is cognitive strategy, next one is verbal information, motor skill, and finally attitude. Right, so all these entities we will discuss in this class, and we will get to know the too much information or explanation about this. Right, very nice. चलिए तो शुरू करते हैं और जानते हैं सबके बारे में कि ये सब चीजें जो है वो किस तरह से explain करती हैं. So motor skill refers to the body movement involving to the muscular activities. For examples, straightening a car, shooting a target, swinging a golf ball, playing cricket, playing basketball, and playing various kinds of the game in which the movement of the body segments takes place come under motor skills. Right, next one is attitude. It's an internal state which affects an individual's choice of action towards some object, person, or event. Examples might be choosing to visit an art museum, writing a letter, pursuit of cause. Now, how you will unveil the internal things in front of people in the events or various kinds of program is called your attitude. Right, the next thing is the verbal information. Verbal information is also having two elements, that is label and facts and bodies of knowledge. Then how we will distinguish both these entities, both these elements, and how they are helpful to understand the verbal information. The very first is label and facts refers to the meaning making to the verbal response to a specific input, and responses many be naming to the site fact and set of facts means there are existing things are there to whom we cannot change, and they are perfect in nature to whom we need to propel to our or preach to our students. Right, for example, name of the objects, this is the very basic level where we try to knowledge or try to remember the things over here. So naming of the objects, people, events, recalling to the person birthday, hobbies, these kind of the things will carry out in label and facts. Other thing is, the other element is bodies of knowledge. In bodies of knowledge, refers to recalling to the large body interconnected regulation. For example, textual materials, studying rules and regulations, for example, paraphrasing or meaning of textual material, studying rules and regulation. So in short, the word for information is body of knowledge acquired by an individual. But cognitive strategy, now we will discuss this. It is an internal process by which the learner controls his own thinking and learning examples, engaging in ourselves to decide how much the study is needed, knowing what sort of questions to ask to best define the domain of knowledge, ability to form a mental model of problem. Means if the word cognitive is using at any part of the educational domain, cognitive related to the mind or intellectual things and strategies making the plans. Okay. If you are cognitive strategies means mentally you are preparing something to solve someone or to do something, right? A pre-planned mental creativity, a pre-planned use of mental activities, intelligence is called cognitive strategy. Next, intellectual skills. Intellectual skills can be classified or can be explained with the support of four levels. The four levels are discrimination, concrete concept, rule using, and problem solving. And final four levels within the intellectual skills domains, Robert identified as his taxonomy. The discrimination is very first element, is making different responses to different members of a particular class, seeing the essential differences between input and responding differently to each. It's example, distinguish yellow finches from house finches on the basis of marking, having to tell the difference between the gates of instrumental panel. Means if two things, they are just very similar to each other, here you have to divide them, or you have to discriminate them into the two various parts. So while if you will separate two similar things from each other, what will you will have to do? You have to show some particular characteristics, they are different from each other, right? So on the behalf of some characteristics, you will divide them, you will separate the two things, right? Second thing is concrete concept. Is responding is a single way to all the members of a particular class of observable events. Means if you are dealing with a particular class and you have to explain our object to all the class, means you are using some basic things. Means why we are using the basic thing? Because there are individuality rule. All the students, they have individual characteristic, individual capability, and individual ability to grab the things. So because of this concrete concept, we use it at basic level. On higher or complex level, we will not use this concrete concept, right? So seeing an essential similarity among the class of objects, people, event, which calls a single response. Example, classifying music as country, western, rock, saying round upon, seeing a manhole cover, a penny and the moon. These kinds of the example can easily explain the concrete concept, right? Next, we will talk on the rule using, right? Rule using means you are applying a particular rule to a given situation or the condition by responding a class for the inputs with the class of action. Relating two or more simpler concepts in particular manner of rule, a rule states that the relationship among the concepts. For example, it is helpful to think our rules or the principles as if then statement. If the task is procedure, then flow charting to analyze the task. If you can convert a statement into if then statement, then it is rule or the principles. Means if you are dealing with a particular system, each and every system, they having some rule and you need to follow the rules, right? If you will use the rules and regulation, definitely you will be able to work with that system conveniently. And the output or the ability to perform with that particular system will be much easier for you if you are using the rules. In adverse condition, you will not be doing such good things without using the rules. So that is why if you are dealing with any organization or the system has some rules and regulation, you need to follow them. The another thing is problem solving. Problem solving means combining the lower rules to solve the problems in a situation never encountered by the person solving the problem. May involve to the generating now rules, which receives the trial and error and until the one solve the problem is found out. Means this is the particular situation in which you have to use your previous knowledge, previous rules, principles to solve a problem. Means if you don't have the previous experiences or the knowledge background to deal with unknown one, you definitely not be able to solve the problem. So we use what are the optimum method that we use to solve the problem, unknown problem, I mean to say. So in that case, we will go for trial and error. We will try, and if there is error, we will retry, right? So till to get the final aim or the final solution, we will use this try and error, and finally we will get the solution. So this was all about the robots method, right? Of the teaching instructional objectives. So we have already covered today, and by tomorrow we will do some other classes related to Bloom's taxonomy, because the Bloom's taxonomy, I have already told you about the Bloom's taxonomy. It was discovered by the Bloom in 1956. Later, after 50 years of synthesis work by done some group of peoples, and they rectified the some of the things they were not fit for the system of education, and finally they reached on a point in which they have do change from the verb formation of that one, right? In previously 1956, Professor Bloom, they have designed this system, designed this taxonomy in the form of noun. So it was not so much convenient to use for design objectives of education. So after a pilot work by doing some of the teachers and group of teachers, and finally in 2001, they have made another replacement or reformation in this taxonomy. In 2001, they convert this taxonomy from noun form, non-form into verb form, and now it is available into verb form and easy to write the objectives or aim of a class to whom you are going to deal with. So we will discuss in next class each and every single element and comparative analysis of Bloom's taxonomy, right? So for today, this is enough, right? We will be meeting in by tomorrow with the next topic, that is Bloom's taxonomy pilot study, right? Okay, thank you.